If we do one more, it's the last one for sure, for sure, for sure. Okay. Only one more. Two more? One more?
Last time on MasterChef. It was a mystery box challenge of epic proportions.
Ew. There's balls, and there's a brain, and there's this massive tongue.
And Ryan came out on top.
It's a great dish.
Putting him in control of the competition.
What kind of a gives a live crab to the blind chick?
It pierced me.
But when his strategy backfired...
You cook like an angel.
Helene was eliminated.
Your time in MasterChef is done.
Tonight... The remaining home cooks get a 3 a.m. wake-up call.
Oh, my God.
And do battle in...
Okay. Spoilers!
It's the middle of the night, and the remaining 14 home cooks are sound asleep at a Los Angeles hotel. But the MasterChef judges are about to change all that.
Good morning.
Oh, my God.
Are you awake?
Yeah.
I hear someone banging on my door. It's 3:30 a.m. and I'm just wondering what the heck is going on.
Today,
do we do Helene lore? Helene Leeds was a health coach and a former model from Baldwin, Maryland. She was eliminated in MasterChef Season 3, Episode 6 after her crab soup failed to impress the judges. After MasterChef, Helene returned to her previous career as a health coach and also a life coach. Pretty good.
Our home cooks are about to get a taste of the life of a professional breakfast chef. That means a very early start.
Move your ass, big boy.
10 minutes downstairs.
Okay, I'll
we're
be
gonna
ready
go.
Get up.
Gotta go. I look at the time, it's like 3 a.m. and I'm like, someone's gonna die for this. Someone's gonna die.
While hundreds of other hotel guests remain asleep, the MasterChef contestants have been told to head down to the hotel's kitchen for their latest team challenge.
So, here you are.
Look at my man, dude. Just a powerful aura, okay? Just a force to be reckoned with, okay? You think just because he has a colorful shirt up, buttoned down, twice low, okay, that he's got a colorful personality? Think twice. This is not bubbly Graham. Season 3 Graham is not bubbly, okay? He's angry. Don't know why. Maybe he started dieting. We did see the spoiler that he lost a lot of weight later on. So maybe this is like the start of the diet where he feels a little, you know, angry all the time. But look at those eyebrows. Look at those angry eyebrows. Those are permanently stapled on Graham's face this season. Okay. It's 3:30. It's Graham o'clock. Okay. He's not angry because it's 3:30. He's angry because his shirt is untucked and he's ready to taste some fucking delicious foods. And he's ready to tell you how it is. Okay. It's like they've substituted slots here.
In a professional kitchen, a moment you've all been dreaming of, but you probably didn't expect it in the middle of the night. Your big challenge this morning is working the early rush, cooking all of the breakfast room service orders at this huge Radisson hotel.
What? Like, none of us have even combed our hair, let alone prepared to go start cooking for like hundreds of hotel guests. It's just mind-blowing.
Listen up, the breakfast rush is the hardest service of the day. People are hungry and they're in a hurry.
I am not what you call a morning person, and breakfast is the last thing I want to make right now.
The dishes that the hotel guests will be ordering this morning are a delicious oatmeal, fresh fruit salad, handmade pancakes, egg white omelette, egg benedict, and of course the all-American classic breakfast. 2 eggs, any style. Simple, straightforward.
I cook breakfast all the time. Actually, it's one of my favorite meals. I cook for my daughter every morning before school, so I know how to poach my eggs, I know how to scramble. I'm feeling pretty good about whoever picks me for their team.
This dog, whenever Big Dog says he feels pretty good, you know he's cooked, okay? Homie has consistently felt good and fucked up, okay? Like when you feel good, it's the top of the hour and an ad break hasn't come yet. And you're thinking like, oh, maybe he forgot. Guess what? No, I didn't. 7 o'clock, right on the dot. Top of the hour, 60-second ad break. You feel good. then you're reminded that there's an ad break. What do you do about it? Well, you know, maybe, just maybe you're lucky enough you get gifted a sub. Probably not going to happen. Okay, how do you do that then? How do you fix it? Well, you fix it by subscribing on your own with a $5 subscription. Well, guess what? You don't have $5. What the fuck? Well, then you subscribe for free with a Twitch Prime. All right, that's how you do it. Guess what? 1 minute ad break now. Thank you, the bride guy, for the five. Get the sub.
Christine and Josh, you had the best dishes.
Thank you.
In the previous challenge.
Whoa, what the both fuck? Holy shit. Thank you, Anika Bonk, five get the subs. KB Nope, five get the subs. Sibin Elm, five get the subs. And Motorboat Snob, 20 get the subs. That's right.
Our team captains, come over, please.
Even though I'm vision impaired, I've gotten to know everyone's cooking styles well enough to know who I want on my team.
Christine, you had the winning dish. You're going to pick first.
This person understands the importance of organization, and because this person works in a restaurant already, my first pick is Felix.
Felix, wow. Good.
I think Felix is a strong team worker, but she also has initiative, and I think that's important to have on a team.
Okay, Josh.
Becky.
Good.
I love breakfast. I used to work in a little breakfast diner, so I'm kind of familiar with a lot of the protocol. It's not about being fancy, it's about being efficient.
My next pick is Scott.
Scott, wow.
Frankie,
good.
My next pick is Tanya.
Tanya, how nice.
Anna.
I need more manpower, so my pick is Mike.
Mike, wow.
Holy shit, Mike without the cowboy hat looks naked, dude. Straight up, just like a different person without the cowboy hat.
Monty, good choice. Christine, next up.
I would love to have Stacy on my team.
Wow. Yeah.
I did not expect to see you three there, let me tell you.
I'm pretty pissed off. How am I put in the same category as Tally or Ryan? Do people honestly really look at me and think that I'm a weak cook? Because if they do, then they got something else coming.
This next person I choose has a really good palate and mind for food. David Martinez.
Being one of the last two to be picked really shows their judgment skills. They can clearly not tell talent when it's right in front of their face.
Christine.
I don't want either one of them on my team, so it's pretty much choosing the lesser of two evils. My last pick is Ryan.
Wow. Tali, come over and join the blue team.
They straight up just don't like Ryan because he just sucks. And Tali, or he's like a bad personality. Tali, on the other hand, just straight up sucks. That's why he's picked last, straight up.
I'm standing there in disbelief. I can't believe
I got a PLD.
I'm the bottom pick right now. I don't deserve to be last. I should be first.
Christine, because you had the best dish in the last challenge, we're giving you another advantage in this challenge. Big one.
Right now, you have the power to switch out one member of your team with one member of Josh's team.
I'll remove Ryan.
Ryan.
This is garbage that I'm getting traded like this. I am not looking forward to it at all.
And who do you want to take?
I'm taking Becky.
Wow.
Becky was Josh's first pick, so immediately I know that it's going to be a thorn in his side and it'll hit him hard, and I know that I'm going to build an even stronger team.
Happy to be here.
Both teams have got 90 minutes to prep and then 90 minutes to serve.
Each team needs one expediter. He or she will be overseeing every cart that leaves, making sure that it leaves within its window of time. It is a hugely, hugely important job. Christine, who do you want as your expediter?
Felix.
Christine picked me as the expediter for her team. I'm a food runner, so I feel completely confident doing that.
And Josh, what about you?
I'm gonna choose Monty on this one.
I'm pretty confident that Monty will be able to perform as the expediter for our team because of her organization skills and the attention that she puts into her plates and every other challenge that we have.
You'll begin serving breakfast at 7 a.m. Excited?
Yes, chef.
Your 90 minutes prep time starts now. Off you go.
In this challenge, the hotel guests have pre-ordered their breakfast and specified a delivery time. Each team has 130 orders. Satisfied customers will hang a tag of the team's color on their door. The team with the least number of tags will face a pressure test.
I want you two cutting the fruit for the fruit salad. I want you to get on the oatmeal. Frankie, I want you on the pancakes.
Josh just says, okay, you're doing this, you're doing that. Just assigns jobs, more of a dictatorship kind of thing. In my opinion, it's...
What did I miss? A trade? I don't want to go back, dude. Go back 30 minutes. I had to fucking pee and grab a diet ginger ale. Christine got to swap a person, said piss off Ryan and stole Becky. Okay, there it is.
It's smart to ask everybody, what is it that you like to make so that people can have passion in what they're doing?
Unlike the blue team, the red team is working out stations democratically.
I'm going to probably do prepping and then egg beating.
Yeah. I'm good with pancakes and proteins.
I can do bacon on the flat tops.
So we huddle up and immediately assess strength and weaknesses. Good start. I definitely think...
The fork that keep that Joe keeps biting. Thank you for the 5 gifted subs.
We're gonna win it.
Big challenge. I mean, first time in a real kitchen. They look like proper chefs.
Yeah, they're in the right outfits.
They just gotta cook like them.
Exactly.
This is all about organization, right?
Everything comes together with the prep here.
My bulletin board. It's got every item that we're cooking. So that way, no one has any questions as to what they have to cook.
I laid out my board in a way where I could read it because I know that I'm going to be the one reading it anyways. And I started prepping to help my team.
Gordon is worried that the red team haven't made nearly enough sauce for their Eggs Benedict orders.
You've got enough portions for hollandaise for 10, and you've got 25 an order. And there's only 35 minutes to go before we start serving.
Chef, I'm confident I can make another batch.
No, hollandaise is not the kind of batch you can make when you start. It's got to be made beforehand. So if I was you, I'd just step up a gear a little bit.
25 minutes left, blue team. 25 minutes on the clock before our orders need to start going up.
The bacon's scorched. You know what I mean? The spinach isn't cooked all the way through. Just make sure you're not going into service and then finding out I can't use that. Monty's going to be expediting, but she's going to be expediting a bunch of plates of crap if you can't get your guys organized.
No, these ones. On this table.
Yo, I swear, these episodes, the Kitchen Nightmare episodes, like, kind of fuck me up a little bit. Because, like, the pace is ramped up so hard. You don't get to see, like, individual personalities. And also, it just, like, gives me anxiety and reminds me that I could never work in a fucking kitchen. I mean, it gives me a newfound appreciation for fucking chefs and shit that, like, work in the kitchen, but it's way too high stress for me, dude. I hate these. It's like, gives me anxiety.
Figure out where else you're gonna cut. I have to expedite on this table. I need you to leave for a moment.
Somebody's getting testy over there.
While expediter Monty is being very
kitchen.
Vocal on the blue team, over on the red team, Captain Christine is becoming increasingly concerned by Felix's silence.
Felix, is there anything you need? I feel like I'm having trouble communicating with Felix, who's my expediter. I'm not getting any feedback, so it's frustrating.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Damn, don't
3,
do this.
2,
don't
1.
Do this. Don't do this, Felix. You're dividing me. I'm simping for both Felix and Christine. This is not good. It's not good. Felix, you gotta, under pressure, like, you're maybe not hearing her, but
7 o'clock.
Those are the two queens, you know?
And the 90-minute breakfast room service begins.
Monty, what do you need next?
Hold on, dude.
Talk to me.
Look at the board. It's right there.
As soon as we started cooking, people stopped looking at the bulletin board and started asking me, how many eggs do I need to cook? I don't know. Why don't you look at the board? I have 150 tickets in front of me, and I have to figure out how to put it all together. Do we have the hollandaise?
Yes. Got it.
Do we have the muffins and the scrambled eggs?
While Monty struggles to keep the blue team on track, the red team is having a total communication breakdown.
Felix, you're the only one that can expedite. We need to get these plates out. We have a server here waiting for the food.
The pressure in this kitchen is insane. It's loud. It's hot.
Nice.
Knives everywhere. I mean, eggs flying, potatoes flying, you know. It's insane.
I got a scrambled egg. I need a plate. You guys get plates.
I don't know what's going on. People are just shouting all around me. Help, Neely! We need to get stuff out. It's chaos right now.
It's the remaining 14 home cooks' first time in a professional kitchen. Each team must cook 130 breakfast room service orders at a busy Los Angeles hotel.
Well done, Monty. Keep it going, huh?
All right.
Really good job.
Go, go, go. Thank you, sir.
The blue team's first orders are quickly moving up to hotel guests. But over on the red team, visually impaired Captain Christine is frustrated at her team's progress so far.
Felix, get the food on the plate. Come in, come in.
Red team, listen to me. The blue team are sending way more rooms than you guys. You've got to lift it up. Come on.
Please tell people what to do, what they need to get on there, okay?
All right, I'm trying my best.
I didn't hear much from Felix, which is key. She's the only one that can look at the tickets and know what needs to go on which plate.
Hey, what do we need? Felix, communicate with them.
She's not pulling help where she needs it, and she's trying to do everything herself.
Right, Felix.
Yes.
Felix.
Yes.
Felix.
Yes.
An expediter needs to talk. And for the last 5 minutes, you've just shut down, and there's no communication going on. You have got to talk to your team.
I'm in way over my head when you have, you know, five people yelling at you.
I feel bad, dude. It's not her fault. It's not her fault. She's not. She's just under a lot of pressure. She's just under a lot of pressure. It's not a big deal. I mean, it just sucks. You know, we all fail sometimes. Gordon, you shouldn't yell at her like that. That's fucked up. Oh my God, I am literally a chatter. I'm the chatter who fucking says, don't you have some water for your guests? Like, I'm that chatter. I'm white knighting right now, straight up.
Well, at the same time, you really can't think. If we lose today, it's gonna be my head on the breakfast platter.
On the blue team, there are no communication issues for Puerto Rican-born Monty, who's yelling out orders in both English and Spanish.
Go, go, go! Otra mesa! Otra mesa!
It's a big difference between the red team and the blue team. The blue team, you know, even though it looks a little bit more frantic and sort of chaotic in there, Monty's actually doing a good job.
More tables, please!
Red team got backed up. All of a sudden, Felix turned into a control freak and wasn't delegated. She's running around like a headless chicken. The expediter, rule number one, is to communicate. Mm-hmm. The minute you stop communicating, you're in trouble.
Otra mesa! Otra mesa!
The blue team has been pumping out orders for more than 45 minutes, so Joe heads upstairs to see if the hotel guests are satisfied.
Good morning, room service.
Hello, we have your breakfast.
Wonderful.
May I come in?
Absolutely.
Do you have the oatmeal and the eggs benedict from the blue team?
Okay.
Great, enjoy it.
The blue team's food was very good. I had the eggs benedict, and it was very flavorful.
I've ordered the pancakes, and I like the consistency of the blue team's, you know, like grandma used to make.
Happy customers mean votes for the blue team. While the blue team gets good reviews upstairs, downstairs, the red team continues to struggle.
We're gonna run out of hollandaise.
As Gordon predicted, the red team has run out of hollandaise, and Felix is cutting corners.
Felix,
yes.
Felix, that's not good enough. Eggs Benedict gets nappéed, and the egg gets covered with hollandaise.
Okay. Nappéed.
This is not a dessert with chocolate sauce. Start again, please.
I hear Felix getting chewed out for putting only a drizzle of hollandaise sauce onto the eggs benedict. Not being able to see and being team captain, it's very difficult. I need my team members to step up and just take ownership of what they're doing.
We need more hollandaise. Make sure we don't run out. Tanya, are you in the hollandaise?
Christine, I'm on it.
Christine is so vocal. It's extraordinary.
She is really kind of rising to the top, as we say. She's taking control.
More importantly, now there's great communication going on.
You guys need to worry about the eggs better. Felix needs to get these out.
Christine's take charge attitude is winning praise from the judges.
Felix is suspended on Twitter. I wonder what she did to get suspended on Twitter.
That matter.
We have the breakfast prepared by the red team for you.
The hollandaise sauce was amazing. The eggs were perfectly cooked. So the red team's healthy omelet. The ingredients were awesome. Presentation was great.
It doesn't have enough flavor, so it immediately needed a little salt and pepper.
25 minutes to go, guys.
The red team continues to get orders out.
Jeannie,
But over on the blue team, Gordon discovers standards are slipping.
$18. Is that it on fruit? Who put the fruit on there?
I did.
Look at me.
I did. That was a mistake on my part.
That's a mistake. No way. No way. No way. Would you pay $18 for that? You know.
To be fair, hotel food is always like that. Let's be real. Like, they literally serve you that and then they call it a day. Like, I mean, now that I know what's going on downstairs, it makes a little bit more sense. But, like, I've never had hotel food that wasn't like that. That wasn't that expensive.
That's not.
Hotel food is great. What the fuck? Dude, what? Room service hotel food is literally straight doo-doo butter, dude. It's just, like, straight trash.
Oops. You're cooking them, he's taking them, you're serving them. It's raw.
We are getting plates out, but the quality of the food that I'm receiving is not up to par. The whole thing's a disaster.
We need an Uber Easy again. This one's broken, and we need 3 orders of scrambled eggs.
Ryan, what are you doing besides watching them work?
I'd ask anybody for help if they need any help.
Okay, let's get organized.
The kitchen is crazy and hectic. I'm looking around at Ryan, and he looks a little confused, standing around looking, wondering what's going on, and I'm getting frustrated.
Things are about to go from bad to worse as Joe heads downstairs with a serious customer complaint for the blue team.
Bro, Joe's got that fucking, whatever the fuck this beard is, whatever this is called, little fucking soul patch. He's pissed.
We have a hair on a plate. Customer sent it back.
Oh, no.
Guys, please.
It's the expediter's role to make sure hair isn't on plates. And so when it comes down to that, I think it all falls down on Monty.
Monty, make sure the plates are clean. We came back with a hair. It's not mine. My hair is this short.
Well, it's not mine. My hair is super long.
Come on, guys. You're better than that.
I think I'm doing a better job than anyone else on my team because they can't handle scrambling an egg. How are they going to handle putting together all these meals?
12 minutes to go until breakfast is over.
Do people actually care? Just take it off and keep eating? What are you, crazy? No, dude. What the fuck? You paid $18 for some sloppy-ass fucking over-easy eggs, and you got a fat-ass hair in there? Get the fuck out of here. It's probably Tolly's, by the way, who's not using a hairnet.
Over, guys. Let's go.
On the red side, carts are rolling. As
none of them have hairnets, which is weird.
Voice.
Let's start setting up these All-Americans. Let's put the potatoes on there. All-American, here are your potatoes.
Meanwhile, on the blue team, a power struggle threatens to destroy their earlier lead.
Let him. Shut your mouth, dude. And I'm
no, you shut your mouth. Shut your mouth, dude.
Guys, we're a team. Stay as a team.
Josh is moving my plate.
XQCL, thanks for the love, kids. Wait. Felix watched this season 3 weeks ago? Holy fuck. That's crazy, dude. 3 weeks ago, he watched this.
Plates around and starts trying to tell me how to work it. It's like, why don't you stick to putting out some delicious food? Because you're not doing a very good job at that right now.
What's the deal with these pancakes? They're getting cold. We need to get them out of here now.
Listen to the blue team now.
I mean, think of it as a ship or a submarine. It's just, it's not even a mutiny. It's just an absolute cluster.
So the cold. Too cold.
No, they're not.
They're too cold. They're not hot. We need hot. They're cold.
Get them going.
They're flappy. Look at this.
Dude, that was a hot. That's ridiculous.
What is going on?
What is going on?
There are massive outbursts between Monty and Josh. I could just see the entire team dynamic falling apart and crumbling around me.
Oh, easy in your face right here. What else do you need?
Yeah, get fucked, guys. Sorry. I love Monty. Love Josh, but get fucked. Actually, queen team to the top, okay?
Okay. A disaster.
Holy, I lost XQCL. Bro, I swear to God, fucking, like, 14-year-olds. I'm Chinese Communist Party on this one, okay? If you're 14 years old, you should not be on Twitch and Instagram at the same time, okay? One or the other. If you're posting XQCK, I lost. Yeah, call me Xi Jinping because I think these kids need only like 1 hour and they need to look at like museum videos or something on the internet, okay? Straight up, bussin'. XQCL, XQCL. Oh my God. Going to the chat said, I'd pay so much for a taste of Felix's hair. I really think that's, I take it back. I think Xi Jinping doesn't go far enough, okay?
Breakfast service at this busy hotel is coming to an end for the remaining 14 home cooks.
Red team, blue team, it's still all to play for. It's neck and neck. Come on, let's go.
All plates must be on the carts by 8:30 a.m. on the dot. So both teams scramble to get their final orders completed.
We need eggs Benedict right now. I got my arm is getting cold.
Behind, hot pan behind.
So it's getting to the end of service, and I'm confident that all our dishes were absolutely delicious.
Pancakes up.
I'm pretty sure that we had the red team beat when it comes to the food.
These ones are ready. Thank you.
It just depends on how much food they all got out, but I'm confident in the flavorings of our food.
Last minute. 1 minute to go.
One more order left, guys.
Let's go.
Scrambled egg. Pork sausage. Wheat. One order of pancakes.
30 seconds to go.
Felix, pancakes.
All right. Beautiful.
Last dishes. I need them now.
Okay, one ticket left.
Nine, eight, seven.
Felix.
Six. Five.
Felix,
get those out.
Four, Felix, run.
Three.
Felix.
It's not happening.
One. And stop. Good job, Blue. Woo! Well done.
Okay, I got those coming.
Time is up, but Felix is still trying to send out food.
Come here. Put it down. Do you want to get disqualified?
No, I don't.
Okay, so you're taking food out. I've already said stop.
Huh?
I've just told you. Time is up.
I'm sorry.
No, look at me. No cheating.
I'm not trying to.
So when I say stop, what does that mean?
That means stop.
I'm not surprised about that team cheating because it's probably the only way.
Shut the fuck up, David. You got picked like third from last, okay? Suck my dick. How dare you? You fucking sit there and you watch Gordo yelling at Felix, a queen, and this is how you react? You dick. Fuck you, David.
I'm gonna win.
I'm just wanting to throw my arms up in the air because I don't know what the hell's going down, and I'm team captain, and I just feel like our team is going under.
This is so much harder than I thought it was gonna be. I wish that I was better organized, that I could have done a better job telling everyone what to do instead of trying to do everything on my own.
Chad is so stupid. David, you served Marines raw pork. David! You compromised our national security, David!
It just breaks my heart that if we lost today, it would be my fault, you know, for not doing a better job.
Bring it in right here. Come on.
Crying and cooking.
Bottom line, you guys, we're home cooks, and we just ran a service for the busiest hotel in the country. It's insanity, dude.
Yeah.
I feel like we have a good chance, considering a lot of the people on that team have never even stepped foot inside the back of a restaurant before.
It's the end of the busy breakfast service. The decision is now in the hands of the hotel guests. As Joe totals up all the door tags from satisfied customers, the teams wait anxiously to find out who won and who will be facing the upcoming pressure test.
I'm super nervous before the judges announce who's going to be going into pressure test. I just definitely don't want to be in that position again.
Joe has collected the results. The scores on the doors are in. Joe.
One team got 60% of the vote, and one team got 40% of the vote.
That's how math works, motherfucker. What kind of take is that? Joe, just stop doing this Gordo shit, okay? You just can't do it. You can't debate. Let Graham do it. Graham is like, he's ready to go, okay? He's running the tightest ship, okay? He's running that McDonald's like a tight ship, okay? He's got the Navy, you know, sergeant attitude this season. Let him do it.
I look at my team, and I'm extremely confident that we're going to win this challenge.
With
60% of the vote, the winning team.
Blue team, it has to be.
Is. The red team.
What?
I really shed tears of joy. We don't have to face the pressure test. Yeah. Oh
my God. Leading a team to victory is a huge accomplishment for me.
It makes me feel good, but also I'm a little shocked. I'm gonna be honest, like that's a little, it seems a little scripted.
I feel awesome, like I've climbed that entire ladder from bottom to top.
Red team, congratulations.
The red team wins a challenge, and wow. It's just awful.
Congratulations, Captain. You led them into victory. Well done. Yeah! Really well done indeed. Blue team, you know what happens when you lose a challenge. Sadly, you're going to face a very tough, a very daunting pressure test where at least one of you will be checking out of the MasterChef kitchen forever.
This sucks. I really did believe we won this one. One of us is...
It's Tali. Has to be. Get him out, dude. He's so weak. I don't even want to look at him anymore, okay? At least he wasn't wearing the trilby this fucking episode.
Gonna go home, and it could be any one of us.
See you back in the MasterChef kitchen. Good job, red team. Well done.
The winning red team heads inside. The blue team prepares itself for the pressure test, knowing for at least one of them, this will be their last day in the MasterChef kitchen.
I freaking totally wanted to avoid every pressure test.
Me too, man.
I wonder what they're conspiring over there.
Today's a competition. You and I are definitely an alliance, but everyone else, I could care less. Clearly, you know who I want to
go
home.
Yeah, we want Monty to go home. Some girls have, like, one screw loose. I feel like she has, like, 30 different screws loose. Monty is to blame for us losing this challenge, and I'll be happy to have the last laugh when my...
Dude, oh my God, I hate him. Monty is also another queen that deserves protection, and Ryan is a piece of shit. I can't even shit on him too much, though. I couldn't really tell if he was fucking up or not.
Monty is walking herself out of the MasterChef kitchen.
I do know Monty did a good job, though.
The capital B.
Except for the hair. The hair was bad.
Yesterday, you were a team. But today, it's every cook for themselves. One of you will be eliminated forever from the MasterChef kitchen.
Three of you will not be competing in this pressure test. Here's the thing, you will not be deciding who's safe. We will.
Oh, here come the scripted ass fucking protection, dude. Here come the scripted ass protection from the judges. Okay, yeah, preserve the content, guys. Let's see it.
I'm praying to every saint that I know that I'm one of those three people.
We scrutinize.
Every saint that I know, Christopher Moltisanti.
We know exactly who the heroes are, and we know who is completely out of their depth.
I'm confident that they're gonna pick me. Clearly, I have to be one of those three.
Joe, who are you sending upstairs to safety?
The person that I think deserves to miss the pressure test did their job in a diligent way. David Martinez. Go upstairs. You're safe.
David, seriously? The guy can't cook, and he's an infectious negative energy in the kitchen.
Graham, for me, it's clear. This person was able to stay focused in the face of chaos. And that person is Frank.
He said raw teeness. It's David fucking Martinez!
Frank and David are safe from the pressure test, and I'm pretty confident I'm the last one.
This person never stopped. Not just across the 90 Monty. Minutes of prep, but across the 90 minutes of service. Right to the very last dish.
Monty.
The person I'm saving. Josh.
What? Oh, no.
It's not you. Monty, upstairs, please.
Let's go. That's well right. Wow.
I'm pissed that Monty's up there safe and not
wow,
me.
That is fucked up, dude. Gordo, you're a piece of shit, dog. That's kind of fucked.
It's like a blow to the gut because I was definitely the backbone of the team.
Not really.
The judges sent by two arch nemesis.
I'll be honest,
up the
not
stairs.
Really.
And now here I am down Sorry. In the trenches having to fight for my life.
So, for the four of you who remain, I'm sorry to tell you, but today's pressure test is a dessert that still to this day terrifies chefs across the world. It involves elements of a cake and a souffle. It's a stunning, technical, molten lava cake. This Ooh. Is not your average dessert. This is a performance. When you slice into one, you should be rewarded with a chocolate gooey surprise. Leave it in the oven too long, you've got a brownie. Take it out too soon, and you've got a mess. All four of you, onto your stations, please. Let's go.
Dude, I love chocolatey gooey surprises, bro. Straight up.
On your stations, you have identical ingredients. Flour, sugar, eggs, chocolate, powdered sugar, cinnamon and butter. And you have four attempts to get the perfect cake. If at any point you think you've nailed it,
hey, yo.
Bring it up to us straight away. Because that is the cake you'll be judged on. Your 45 minutes starts from now. Good luck.
Creating a perfect molten lava cake requires preparing a batter with the exact amount of a few basic ingredients. The cake must be removed from the oven at precisely the right moment, just long enough for the outside to cook while the inside remains liquid. 1 second either way can be the difference between success and failure.
This is a real pressure test. The temperature in the oven has to be hot enough to sort of almost crisp up the outside.
Right, but still mm-hmm. liquid in the center.
What about flavor?
Rich. You know, intense.
Not too sweet, though.
Not too sweet.
Not too sweet, almost a little bitter. Yeah.
What's the strategy for this test?
The strategy now is to make the mix, mm-hmm. split it into four, get one in the oven first, and then adjust and use that first one as a dummy run.
First one's a trial.
Absolute, definitely. Yeah, absolutely.
Who might be crazy enough of these four contestants to bring up their first one?
Tally.
Right now, it's just a matter of getting the chocolate mixture ready for the lava cake. I got two ovens and two hands and four ramekins is what my life comes down to.
I don't deserve to be in a press test. The fact that Chef Ramsey said Monty was vocal the whole time absolutely pissed me off.
10 minutes gone. You've got to get one in the oven. Right.
Hey, Chef.
How are you feeling?
I'm very nervous.
You're sort of disappearing. Almost like a little mouse, and yet I get so frustrated because you can cook.
I can.
Good luck.
Thank you.
How are we doing, Ryan?
I'm not much of a baker, I guess. Okay. So this wasn't like my dream pressure test.
Do you think that you belong down here?
I mm-hmm. think Monty should definitely be down here.
Monty.
Yeah, 100%.
What happened?
Dude, he's like, bro, they're both like, both him and Josh are both like, yo, fuck Monty. They're like ruthlessly fucking whipping while still angry at Monty, dude. Oh, Monty, no.
It was a complete communication breakdown. She didn't operate the team well. She didn't handle the prep time right. She didn't add up the numbers right. She didn't have a good system.
It's not true.
You know, she might have been vocal, but she was vocal in all the wrong ways.
Ryan, you dude. You deserve to go home. You're a jerk.
I just guess I'm just a little frustrated, but I'm not going to let it affect my food.
You know what it means? Honestly, I would love to just slap him around.
I know Ryan rubbed a lot of people in the wrong way.
Dude, that's my... Dude, I love Frank, okay? Frank is the fucking man. Like, straight up, quietly cool as fuck. Everything about this dude, I misjudged. And that honestly is anti-Italian, you know, racism right there. That's just Italiophobia. I thought he was going to be like You know, hey, how you doing? I'm fucking Frank. I'm like a fucking Italian stockbroker, like, which is weird. I say that because one of my best friends is also a very Italian financial analyst, and he's one of the nicest dudes on the planet. Chris, Christopher DeFalco, he's like one of the nicest fucking guys. One of the nicest guys I ever known.
But there's a softness to him and a kindness to him and a spirit to him that is unmatched.
...15 minutes gone. There's got to be something in the oven in order for you to test.
Tally, how many have you got in? What's your strategy?
I got two in going right now.
Two off the first batch.
Yeah, so...
So who in this group of four is going to go home today?
Ambi Raises have a black friend? No, I'm... The racism against Italians part is a joke, my friend. But the stockbroker being like from New York, stockbroker guy, being a douchebag is absolutely what I was thinking. But the reason why I should have remembered that I shouldn't feel that way is because of...
15 minutes gone. There's got to be something in the oven in order for you to test.
Tally, how many have you got in? What's your strategy?
I got two in going right now.
Two off the first batch.
Yeah, so...
So who in this group of four is going to go home today?
I think Josh is going to go home.
Josh?
Yes.
Maybe your buddy Ryan might go home.
I hope Ryan doesn't go home.
Remember, these take minimum 15 minutes to cook. If you don't have them in the oven, better do it now.
They were all too late putting the first one in the oven, because how are you going to test it?
Cooking blind.
Cooking blind? You've got to be looking at the first test coming out of the oven now.
I don't see any coming out of the oven yet.
No.
The way Ryan is, what is he doing? Is he cooking?
Ryan's got
one. He's got one.
It looks undercooked from here.
Mm-hmm.
Ryan's just going to collapse.
It's definitely raw.
Let's see.
Yo!
This is diarrhea on a plate.
That's too gooey! Let's go! Get fucked!
The first one that I put in was intended to be a test run.
Dude, I'm such a fucking fatty. I would literally lick that shit off the plate. Like, I don't even give a fuck that it's raw.
All the way. I wanted to try to feel out the timing of it. I just hope that my second one is more firm.
I look in the oven and my first one, it's not baked. So I am freaking out.
If it's undercooked, it's gonna sink.
It's gone.
Josh's has collapsed.
7 minutes to go.
When pulling the second one out, it looks much firmer than the first one did. Now, my entire fate lies in the last one.
5 minutes to go.
Tonight's pressure test is to bake a perfect molten lava cake.
At any time now, you can serve.
The home cooks get just 4 chances and 45 minutes to cook, test, and present one perfect gooey-centered cake to the judges.
5 minutes remaining. Come on.
But with time running out, no one has presented their cake.
I was going to cut into this as a test, but my other cake's probably been there just as long. So I said to myself, you know what? I'm going to take a gamble, and this is going to be the cake to present to the judges.
Are you serving that, Tali?
I'm serving it.
I want to hear. Let's go. Let's go, then. Right. You happy with that?
I hope so.
Clapped. No shot. Oh, not bad. He did it, but it tastes bad though.
He has oozed out. Maybe too much ooze. A little too much. I think it was a touch underdone.
4 minutes to go.
Dude, honestly, like, maybe Tali, when not left to his own devices to figure out what the fuck he wants to make, can actually cook. This is kind of like the first time where he had like very clear parameters. So maybe that's why he kind of did it. You know what I mean? Because like up to this point, every time they're like, yo, do whatever you want to do, Tali's like, okay, I'm going to make a rutabaga chicken dish with a tuna melt on top. And it's like, what the fuck are you doing? That's such a psychotic fucking, like, where did you come up with that? It's like so stupid that none of that works with each other. Tali is technically proficient, but has like zero competency when he has to come up with a dish. He's like, yeah, he's like, I'm a visionary. Exactly.
I take my cake out of the oven. Oh my God.
Good job,
man. Beautiful. And I can tap the surface. It has a little dimple in it. It looks good. And I am so relieved. I'm serving in 15 seconds.
Dude, this music is so tense.
Look at that.
That's better than the fucking judges one, dude.
Good job.
Yeah. I can tell by the facial expressions of the judges, it's good. Gordon seems a little smug, but what's new?
3 minutes to go. Come on.
When I pull out my second molten lava cake, I feel like this is the best I can do within the amount of time.
2 minutes to go, come on.
Ooh, nice job, Josh.
Serving in 15 seconds, chef.
I'm extremely happy. This cake is a beautiful sight to see.
All right, Josh.
Oh, looks great, Josh.
Every chatter so far has pointed out that, like, Domino's makes a lava cake. I've never had it, but, like, I got it, bro. Yeah, Domino's makes a lava cake, too, okay? Chatter, stop bringing up Domino's lava cake challenge. I gotta run that back. Look at Graham. Graham is so excited, bro. Look at this. Look, look. Look at Graham. Watch what he does in the background with the fork. Watch. Just tapping his hand, dude. He's like, come on. He's like, I swear to God, that's me, dude. That's me. Straight up.
Good job, Josh.
Thanks. Seconds to go.
I'm freaking out right now. There's only a minute left, and every second counts.
Jeez, dude. Are you crazy?
45 seconds. Let's go.
He overcooked it. No shot.
30 seconds to go. Run. Hurry up.
Bring the plate. Go.
10. Come on.
Walk it. Walk it.
Go, go, go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and serve.
Oh no. Tali outlived Ryan? Are you kidding me? Tali outlived Ryan? This is what I meant when I fucking said Tali gets a benefit for being content, and then he actually outcompetes cooks that are literally better than him.
Wow. Straw in your back pocket.
I am so bummed out right now. I'm not a scientist in baking in the kitchen. I'm a magician in the kitchen, and this does not lend well towards me. I'm just hoping at this point that it tastes better than the other people's cakes.
What? It's like three ingredients, dog. Good luck. Like,
tastes good. Unfortunately, it's undercooked.
But Thai's is very flowery.
Absolutely.
To me.
And it's too sugary.
Mm-hmm.
In the mix, especially in the middle, too, not cooked.
Oh, dude. No. No shot. No shot. They're literally gonna fucking salvage him for the content. I hope they keep him for the content. I'm sorry. GG's to the lady. GG's to Josh. I don't care. That's content.
That was definitely 45 minutes of pressure. Let me tell you. Josh, Anna, step forward, please. Both of you, in our minds, produced a molten lava cake of pure perfection. Congratulations. Josh showed great precision because you did work under pressure and you nailed that pressure test. Really good job.
Anna, your cake was as good as any cake you could have in a restaurant. And quite frankly, you took a pressure test and turned it into a demonstration for the rest of these contestants on how to create baking perfection. Congratulations. We've never seen anything like that.
Thank you.
You nailed it.
Thank you, Chef.
Take you and Josh upstairs to the balcony. Well done.
So I'm there with Ryan, my closest ally.
Bro, Polly literally looks like a fucking magician pickup artist rolled up into one. Like, at least Ryan is a bit more content, you know what I mean?
And either one of us could go home right now. This is no joke.
Ryan, Tali, you've bonded in this competition.
This really sucks. How could they possibly destroy the dream team so early on?
One of the molten lava cakes stood up. Tasted flowery,
mm-hmm.
Tasted bland, was cold in the center. The other one tasted good, but it wasn't cooked sufficiently.
I hope Ryan goes home today. He does not belong in the MasterChef kitchen.
Yo, that's fucked.
Ryan is taking.
Oh, they cook Tali, okay? That's like unacceptable. That's straight up unacceptable. One at least completed the assignment, the other didn't. That's completely unacceptable.
A lot of punches in this competition so far, but he's not a bad person.
Tali's got to go home. If you can't put flavor on the plate, you're not going to put it past these judges.
I think both of them need to go home.
Yes, Christine is right.
Kitchen is... Ryan, Tali, I'm going to turn this around.
Wait, what?
I'm gonna ask that individual who knows who he is that didn't produce a stunning molten lava cake to act on integrity and to be noble and to come up here.
Dude, they're such dickheads, dude. He's literally doing this because he knows they're both fucking, they're both assholes. He wants to turn them against each other for extra content. That's crazy. Almost as crazy as paywalling this kind of content behind a fucking 60-second ad break at the top of the hour and then telling you that the only way to see an uninterrupted ad-free broadcasting experience is by subscribing to avoid those ads at the top of the hour. You know what I mean? Because at the top of the hour, sometimes 10 minutes early, sometimes not. The fork tech joke keeps biting. They give it the five, get the subs, string speaks. Five, give the subs. You get the... I can't even... That was such a good fucking segue, dude. That was... so good. Hey, listen, if you want an ad-free broadcasting experience, baby, all you need to do is subscribe. Get a gifted sub or subscribe for $5 or for free. Here's the one-minute ad break now.
Here.
Thank you, Rabbits Not, for the five gifted. Thank you, Dr. Gons and Ismail's Mail. And Loathing Leon.
Hand me their apron.
For the five gifted as well. And Boy Grunge. That's fucked, dude. There's no need to do that. I thought you said you don't like ads. Nah, dude, I love ads. Pepela, that's fucked, dude. Oh, no. My man went from Pepela to that's fucked, dude. Hey, guess you didn't know, bitch. That's right, chatter. Cholesterol levels have gone down now because of that segue. Yeah. Every time I fucking deliver a solid ad segue, my cholesterol levels drop. Chatty plays in Luna Lux. Thank you for the gifted. Also, I didn't fucking play. I stalled for the ad break to end. So nobody actually missed out on the content. Get fucked. Get double fucked. That's called a double debate, bitch. Yeah, that's right. The ad break is over. Thank you, Statstick and Omega's Miso. The five gifted.
Oh my gosh.
Tali, upstairs.
I thought it was a noble move by Ryan to give his apron up. Ryan was my really close friend, and now I carry the torch for the both of us.
How you feeling?
Disappointed.
You're disappointed? We're disappointed. So far, you've handled pressure in the competition brilliantly. I did not expect you to present a molten chocolate soup on that plate.
Thank you, Ryan.
Please take your apron and put on your station.
Dude, that sounds so bad. That's so sad. Just kidding, bro. Just kidding. Just kidding, bro. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, no, you feel sick to your stomach? Dude, that feels so sad. Just kidding. Yep. Okay. Sorry.
That this is the note that I'm going to be leaving on. This has been an incredible experience for me. I'm very thankful for having the chance to show the judges what I could do.
Thank you very much.
I met a lot of great people. I wouldn't trade it for anything. This has reinstilled in me how good of a cook I am. I guarantee that you have not seen the last of the flavor elevator.
Ryan Lohr. Ryan Umane was unemployed and from New York City. He was eliminated in MasterChef Season 3, Episode 7 after Gordon asked Ryan or Tali to give up their plays and he gave up his jacket. After MasterChef, Ryan started catering company Flavor Elevator Incorporated and is also a real estate agent. Of course he is. Where's the sexual harassment in his highlight reel? Yeah.
Was a serious pressure test. From now on in.
Wait, that lore is old. Ryan is now an intuitive empath, light worker, and energy healer and goes by the spiritual name Tango Sparks and sells energy healing sessions. Are you serious? Oh my God. It's fucking raw! Oh no, he's a crystal daddy. Let's go. Tango Sparks has dedicated the last decade to both intellectual and experiential meditation practices. Last decade? Motherfucker, we saw you last decade. We saw you last decade. You were not spiritually healing at all, bro. Oh, no. And is committed to teaching others how to raise their consciousness. He's teaching people how to be more sexist, dude. He's like... And through the practice of love and self-awareness, Tango is architect of a new energy healing modality. Unfortunately, Tango is not an architect for a fucking molten lava cake that you can get at Domino's Pizza. It embodies the principles of neuro-linguistic programming, emotional freedom techniques, the law of attraction, sound healing, and cognitive behavioral therapy. His Instagram is wild. Oh, stop. Wanted to get an interview for Galactic Federation, finding out it already happened interdimensionally and you didn't make the cut? The devil whispered in my ear, "You're not strong enough to withstand the storm today." I whispered back in his ear, "I am the storm." r/ I'm 14 and this is deep. Okay, one more.
Feeling sluggish today? Are you feeling a little bit tired? Sometimes the energy can feel a little heavy. A nice little tip that I like to...
This is the time to show them your nipples? Bro, people are fucking brutal, dude.
Sometimes I buy some Epsom salt, buy a big bag of it, and take a bath. Give yourself some you time, and that Epsom salt will drain out any toxins in your system, and it'll make you feel so much better.
Chat, stop saying looks like you, okay? Fuck off, dude.
Better.
This is you if your Twitch channel didn't take off. That is so mean. Y'all are just rude, okay? Y'all are just straight rude, homie.
What is freedom? Freedom to be ourselves, freedom from our own thoughts, freedom from the life that we think or that we thought was what was our destiny, freedom to change from one moment to the next, freedom to live authentically, freedom to express ourselves. I guess before I had thought there was only one or two types of freedom, but now I think of freedom as all-encompassing, as something
what's he looking at?
To not strive for, but to be in, if that makes any sense. Be in.
Oh my God.
Your freedom.
Bro, this is... I'm scared. Let's look at Graham again. He is so tactical. Graham is the most tactical out of the three. Straight up. He is absolutely the most tactical. You know, he's like, he's ready for the flood. He's ready for all types of combat. Ryan and Tali have a song you didn't see.
We're gonna turn it up. Get some rest. You're gonna need it.
Okay, do we watch another one? You guys want one more?